Welcome back to today's episode of TNN. We're your hosts, Rosalyn and
Brianna.
Okay.
I see myself being an actress.
I see myself being an detective.
No.
I see myself working at McDonald's.
Where do you see yourself in 5 years? 10 years?
I see myself as a construction worker.
10 years? How old would I be?
21.
How old are you?
He's 12.
I'm 12.
21. No, 22.
I'm
22. I'll be 23. I'll be working.
I'll
be paying bills.
I'll be 23.
I'll be poor. I'll be crying in my room.
In 10 years, I hope to be retired and maybe have a grandchild.
I see myself in 10 years in the Bahamas at the beach.
I see myself as a construction worker, like my dad.
I'm up in this video just to photo bomb, but in 10 years, I see myself, how old am I? I'm in 23, with a big house and a lot of money.
Yep.
I have my doctorates in 10 years in music conducting.
Myself in 10 years, probably with a couple of kids, and living a good life. I think that's how I see myself.
In 10 years, I see myself retired. Sleeping in every day, reading books, traveling, maybe subbing here once or twice a week.
That's nice.
Ready? I would like to be in 10 years. I've been teaching 25. I would like to be retired in 10 years and taking it easy.
10 years, I see myself being even balder, sitting in the same spot.
Oh.
What I see myself in
10
years is...
Period.
What is the question?
And my mom
told me. Nah. Oh.
Look.
What do you see yourself in 10 years?
A rapper. Nigga, you can't even rap. Go. You can't even rap.
What's up, guys? What's the question?
What do you see yourself in 10 years?
Maybe in like a basketball league, maybe.
Basketball league.
Yeah.
See myself in 10 years. Here.
In 10 years, I am hoping to be teaching possibly in another country like Mexico. When my husband and I decide to go build our house down there and retire, he'll retire, but I want to continue teaching in the country.
So I see myself as carrying birthdays, probably still playing clarinet or any kind of instrument, and just having all my family around. Probably gonna move to Colorado or Mexico and get to learn the language and culture. So yeah, that's where I'll be in 10 years.
What I see myself in 10 years? I want to go to the WNBA.
In 10 years, I see myself, hopefully, with grown children going on lots of vacations.
How do you see yourself in 10 years?
Oh, probably right here at Trainer teaching you guys.
Why are we so close to each other? Now let's interview Miss Pettigrew.
Good morning, I'm Alex, and I'm here with Miss Pettigrew to know them a little better. Miss Pettigrew, are you ready to start?
Yes, I am.
Miss Pettigrew, what do you do here at Trinity?
I am an EL teacher and I work with students whose first language is something other than English. I have all of the what are considered our short-term ELs as well as students that are longer-term ELs.
All right. How long have you been at Trinity?
This is my 10th year at Trinity.
What is the best part of working here?
Oh, I love our students. Our students and our families. It's been nice since I've been here as long as I have that I have a lot of siblings of past students coming through, and so it's nice to be able to have that opportunity to continue to work with the same families.
What inspired you to be a teacher?
I was working in corporate America for 14 years, and at one point I just realized that I didn't have that much of an impact. I was working for a company that was huge and multinational, and I was just a spot on their bottom line, which is all they looked at me as is a little bit way to make money. And so I wanted to do something a little more important. So teaching was what I decided to do, because I could look at my life and some of the most influential people in my life were teachers.
Where would you be if you didn't become a teacher?
One of the things that I look at now is if I had the knowledge I have now back then, I would have been a marine biologist.
Okay. What's your favorite food?
My favorite food? Oh my goodness, that's a hard mix. I really like food. Probably tacos. I don't know. I have a lot of favorite foods, but it's just that's what pops in my head.
Do you have any hobbies?
I like to travel, I like to garden, I do a lot of photography, not at school.
Have you ever traveled out of your country?
I've been to Portugal and Spain, Italy and Greece, and I've been to a lot of islands in the Caribbean,
Do you have a dream vacation?
My dream vacation would be actually to go on safari in Africa. I want to see giraffes in the wild.
That's cool. What's the best advice for trainer students?
Is you may not realize it now, but getting an education is really important. It gives you a lot more options to control what you can do in the future. So just to take your education seriously and not wait too late to do that.
The family, our survey question this week, where do you see yourself in 10 years?
In 10 years, I will be retired, and so I will be doing more traveling and doing a lot more just gardening and having that time to spend in the yard,
okay.
if I'm home.
Yeah. Thank you for letting us to know you a little better. Don't forget to say hi to Miss Pennydale and when you see them around the building. Go Vikings!
Go Vikings!
This week's game is who can eat the most spicy chips?
TNN. Today we're doing the spicy chip challenge. And here are the rules. You can't spit the chips out or you're disqualified. You can eat as much as you want, but you can't spit them out, like I said before. You have to finish the bag to win, and there's no water.
Period.
Here are the contestants we have.
All right. We have Joseph, Latega, Jazzy, and Jacob.
3, 2, 1, go!
We're left blooded.
You guys can't tap out. Okay.
It's all good.
Focus on Joseph. Winner Joseph, do you have anything to say about the spicy chips?
I'm just the goat.
I'm just the goat.
for this week.
Hey, Trainer Vikings, it's Miss Virgil. I hope you have a wonderful 3-day weekend this weekend. Get some rest, relax, come back. And when we come back, let's get that focus back on grades, being on time, and being kind to everybody. It's the most important thing, and I promise it'll pay off big in your futures. Be good. Love you.
Wrestling and girls' soccer is coming up. Make sure you turn in your waivers, okay? To me or to Chach, if you played a sport before or this year, let me or Chach know so we can change your waiver to the other sport. Okay, thank you.
Hey guys, this is Mr. Nevins here. I'm going to be coaching wrestling along with my counterpart, Mr. Elliott. You'll meet him on Tuesday. Practice starts Tuesday. There are no tryouts, so please come out, right? We'll figure it out from there. Sixth graders are welcome. You cannot compete, but you're more than welcome to practice with us, and I would definitely recommend that if you were thinking about wrestling next year. There are two teams. There's the boys' team and the girls' team. They'll be separated during matches, okay? You do not have to wear singlets. PE clothes are more than welcome, right? Practice starts on Tuesday. I'll see you there.
I'm a 2021 Olympian and 2021 World Silver Medalist, and today we're gonna be going over my fireman's carry to a dump. I have been hitting this fireman's carry since about middle school. It's always been one of my go-tos, bread and butters, and it's just stuck with me to the senior level. It's helped me make teams win a group level medal. So, I think, she steps back, knee down, double knee, tight here, waving to the crowd. My mom's sitting in the stands over there. Hey mom, one down, hip, shoulder, head.
Hi, this is Kenny Monday, 1988 Olympic gold medalist, 1989 world champion, three-time Olympian. Today I'm going to illustrate one of my favorite moves, the lateral drop. And putting the weight into his shoulders where I can get the pin. So when I throw him here, okay, here. So I'm pressing with my chest and my shoulders, my feet are wide. He turns away from me. I'm really focusing on this shoulder. I'm keeping tight with my arm, my elbows to my body. Turns into me, I go the other side, right, and press with my chest.
As I collar tie, as I go, I'm gonna throw his head over top of me towards the mat. So just right before he touches me here, I'm throwing him over top. Really get his hands to the mat, and now I'm behind him with my duck.
Thanks for watching this week's episode of TNN. Go Vikings!
Turn it up.